Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 3.3, Problem 14. This is Section 3.3, it's problem number 14. It says the amount of time that Math 119 students spend on their homework has a mean of 50 minutes and a standard deviation of 8 minutes. So again, the average being 50, standard deviation of 8 minutes means on average from one student to the next, the difference in the amount of time they spend on their homework is 8 minutes. It says, how much time does a student spend on their Math 119 homework if their z-score is 2.1, 1.2, negative 0.7, negative 1.8, positive 3.7? So the previous problem had nice whole number of z-scores that we could just reason out. This one isn't quite as easy. So what we can do is take the z-score formula for A. So z equals x minus the mean over the standard deviation. So for part A, they're saying the answer came out to 2.1. And that equals x, that's what we're looking for. What is the number of minutes they spent on their homework, minus the mean, the average value, which is given to us as 50, over the standard deviation, which is 8. So now I want to solve for x. The fact that it's a fraction makes it seem tough, but let me just do this. It's an equation, so left side of the equation times 8, right side of the equation times 8. 8 times 2.1 should be 16.8, and it is, equals x minus 50. So now, if we want to solve for x, let's just add 50 to both sides and get the x by itself. Plus 50 on the right side, plus 50 on the left side. So 16.8 plus 50 would be 66.8 equals x. Negative 50, positive 50 cancel. So if the z-score is positive 2.1, the amount of time that that student spent doing their homework is 66.8 minutes. A little more than an hour. So the next one, B, what if their z-score is positive 1.2? So take the same formula, except now for z we'll put in 1.2, this is what they tell us to use, equals x, the number we're looking for, minus the mean. The mean is still 50. The problem says so. The mean, the average is 50, over the standard deviation, which is 8. So same process, because this has a fraction, it looks tough, I'd like to cancel the denominator. So I'm going to do left side of the equation times 8 equals the right side of the equation times 8. I'll just cancel it. So 8 times 1.2 should be 9.6. And then on the other side, some stuff for over 8 times 8, the 8's cancel. So it equals x minus 50. Solve for x, I'm going to add 50 to both sides. 9.6 plus 50 is 59.6, just a tiny bit shy of an hour. On the other side, the negative 50, positive 50 cancel. I have x is 59.6. And now how about a negative z-score? Part C. How many minutes if the z-score is negative 0.7? So if the average is 50, negative z-score is going to mean they spend a little less than 50 minutes on their homework, like 40-something minutes. So I just make a little room and then use the same formula. So now the z for part C is negative 0.7. Don't lose the negative. Equals x, that's what we're trying to find. How many minutes did that student study? Minus the mean is still 50, over the standard deviation, which is still 8. Now, I'd like to get rid of the 8 in the denominator. So, the left side of my equation times 8 is equal to the right side of my equation, also times 8. Do anything I want, as long as I do the same on both sides. 8 times negative 0.7 is negative 5.6. equals, and on the right, my 8's cancel, leaving me with x minus 50. Now I want to solve for x, so let me add 50 on both sides. So positive 50 and negative 5.6 would be 44.4. It's almost 45 minutes. And now D, how many minutes does a student spend studying their Math 19 homework if their z-score is negative 1.8? So let me make some room here this time. And again, I'm going to start with this formula. The z is what they're telling me is negative 1.8. Again, don't lose the negative. Equals, set up my fraction, x is the unknown, how many minutes they spend studying, minus the mean or average value, which is given to be 50, so minus 50, over the standard deviation, which again is, in this problem, 8. Now I want to solve for x. I want to start by canceling the 8 out of the denominator. So it's an equation. Let me multiply both sides times 8. So negative 1.8 times 8 equals x minus 50 over 8 times 8. And now 8 times negative 1.8. Let me just make sure with the calculator. Negative 14.4. Again, pay attention to the negative. And on the right, the 8's cancel. X minus 50 over 8 times 8. The 8 on the top, 8 on the bottom. I have x minus 50. Get the x by itself. I want to get rid of the minus 50. So let me do plus 50 on both sides. And now on the left, negative 14.4 plus 50 will be positive 35.6 equals, and on the right, the negative 50, positive 50 canceled equals x. So again, a negative z-score is giving me an answer that's less than the average. The average is 50 minutes. The student's spending a little more than 35 and a half minutes, 35.6 minutes actually. And finally, part E, how about 3.7? So your 3.7 standard deviation's above average. So that's going to be quite a bit more than the average value of 50 minutes. So Z is 3.7 equals X, the number of minutes the student spends studying, that's what we're trying to figure out, minus the mean, the average value is 50, over the standard deviation, which is 8. So now solve for x. Again, cancel the 8 out of the denominator. So I'm going to multiply both sides of my equation times the value in the denominator, which in this case is 8. So on the left, 8 times 3.7, 29.6. equals x minus 50. The 8's again cancel. So now get the x by itself, cancel that minus 50. I'm going to do plus 50 on both sides of my equation. And on the left side, 29.6 plus 50 will be 79.6, almost 80 minutes. And on the right, negative 50, positive 50 cancel. 79.6 equals x. So well over an hour.